Welcome to Ami's Cooking. I'm Ami. Hi friends, today I'm making fancy sweet rose mango coconut balls. The unique combination of rose and mango, it makes it so delicious. And it's effortlessly made in microwave. These beautiful rose mango coconut balls you can use for any ceremonies like wedding, anniversaries, or even on birthday parties. Kids as well as all the adults would love these. So these beautiful rose mango coconut balls will surely impress your guests. So let's see what basic ingredients we need to make these rose mango coconut balls. I have divided 3 cups of coconut, 1 cup in each. The first cup I'll be flavoring with ready-made rose syrup from the Indian store. It's easily available and also not so expensive. The second one, I will keep it white and use cardamom powder to flavor the white coconut. The third one, I'll be flavoring with ready-made mango pulp, which is easily available in Indian grocery stores. And again, it's not so expensive. So these are our 3 flavors for the rose mango coconut balls. I kept about a half cup of coconut just to garnish. I will roll the balls in it and it will look like snowflakes. I have 3 tablespoons of ghee clarified butter. And I have 1 cup of condensed milk, which I will divide into 3. And use into the 3 flavors of coconut, 1/3 cup in each. First, I'm gonna combine all the ingredients and make it ready to microwave. So the first one I have is with rose flavor. So I'll be adding the rose syrup in it. And I have 1/3 cup here. So I'll be using 1/3 cup of condensed milk. This is 1/3 cup of condensed milk I'll be adding into the first mixture. I did not dry roast my coconut because when we put in the microwave, it's gonna warm up a little bit and it will definitely release some oil from the coconut and it will enhance the flavor. So there is actually no need to dry roast the coconut. The second one is white coconut. So I'll be flavoring with about 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom powder. And now I'll be adding the 1/3 cup of condensed milk. And mix it well. Now I'll be preparing the mixture of mango pulp and the remaining condensed milk. This is 1/3 because I took 1 cup and I use 1/3 in each, so this was remaining 1/3 cup, so no need to measure. Mix it well. See, they already look so beautiful and it will taste amazing too. I did not add any extra colors in it. Now I'll be adding about 1 teaspoon of ghee in each. Again, mix it well and keep the spoons separate so that the colors do not combine in each other. My mixtures are ready to put in the microwave. Let's put the mango mixture first, 1 minute at a time. This mixture does not have to be cooked so much. All we need to do is to combine it and make a soft dough so that we can roll the balls. It's slightly warm. I can smell the mango, also the coconut. It releases some coconut oil and enhance the flavor. I think I'm gonna put it for one more minute because mango has more moisture. I think this is good enough. This mango mixture is ready now. Now we will let it cool down while we cook other mixtures. Now I'll be cooking the coconut mixture for 1 minute. This is plain coconut mixture and I don't think we need more than 1 minute to cook this mixture because it does not have much moisture, just the condensed milk moisture. And the aroma of coconut is already released. This rose mixture also I'll be cooking for 2 minutes because it had more moisture from the rose syrup. I cooked the rose mixture for 2 minutes too. So mango and rose mixture I cooked for 2 minutes each and 1 minute for the white coconut mixture. So altogether 5 minutes was the cooking time. Now we're ready to roll the balls. First, I will take a little bit of ghee and grease the plate. With the same ghee, I can just grease my palm a little bit so that the ball rolls nice and smooth. First, we're gonna make the balls of mango mixture. We want to make the 3 size balls of each mixture, small, medium, and large. See, I have 3 size balls, small, medium, and large. Same way, I'll be making 3 size balls of the white coconut mixture. Now we're ready to make our rose mango coconut balls. So first, let's grease our hand just a little bit. Now start with the medium ball. And make a little bit space in between. And put the small ball. So you start with medium, put the small ball in between. And cover the ball. So we started with the medium ball and stuffed the small ball in it. Now we're gonna rest it for a minute and flatten the large ball. And stuff this ball in it. If your ball does not cover like this, you can add a little bit on top of it and just cover it completely. Just make sure that you cover the ball completely. This looks like a big ball, but we're gonna cut it in half and then serve, so it won't be so much. Now we can roll in the white coconut and rest it here. Now it's time to make another ball. Like I said, start with the medium one and stuff the small one in it. And make a ball. See, this is fully covered now. Now we're gonna rest it for a minute and flatten the large mango ball. And it will be mango mixture outside. And again roll into the white coconut and rest it in the plate. Now we will be making the final ball using rose as the medium ball. Flatten the ball again and put the mango one inside. Flatten the white coconut ball and put the stuff ball in it. Again, we need a little bit more to cover. Once you start pressing like this, it comes together and becomes smooth. It does not take too long to make a nice smooth ball. And it's all ready. My rose mango coconut balls are ready. I could make about 10 balls out of the 3 mixtures I made. So let me try one. I'm gonna try the one which has the rose outside, mango in the middle, and the white coconut in the center. This tastes absolutely divine. Rose mixture, mango mixture, and the white coconut mixture with cardamom, all three together tastes fantastic. This sweet is definitely crowd pleaser. So whenever you make, you let me know how you did it, and if you need any help, just write in the comment box and I will reply to all your comments as soon as I can. So please do enjoy this easy and creative recipe. Please like and share this video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.